friends. Good morning. It is 5 a.m. on Thursday. I really did not sleep. Obviously, I'm sitting here with a cup of coffee, so I've been awake since before 3. So I got about 3.5 hours of sleep, maybe. It's Ragnar Day. I've been having a lot of stress related to my day job, and I'm ready to run away. So that stress is definitely impacting my sleep, but it's Ragnar, baby. I feel like I'm moving. My friend's gonna be here in about 1.5 hours to pick me up, so time to start getting ready. Okay, so I am now dressed. Sun is starting to come up. My ride is about 10 minutes away. So I'm here with all my stuff. Oh my gosh, all the stuff. I don't know if this is gonna come. That's my rolling cart. I hope we can bring the rolling cart. It would make it so much easier to pack in and out, but it'll depend on how much room we have in the car. So that is optional. This is the main stuff. Here we are. We are pulling into the Ragnar Florida Trail event. Clearly not a typical road we would come down. We got a little nervous because the Google map told us to turn, I don't know, a while back, but here we are. We found the sign. We're going down the grassy road. Okay, here we are. We are in line on the road to check in for Ragnar. We had a very long drive.
Very
long drive. So Jody left her house at 5:20 to come pick me up, and that part of the drive was easy, but of course picking me up put us very close to Atlanta, which sucks on a good day. So right. That took a long time. Once we were on the highway, it went really fast, but then when we got close, like the last hour, it was really only like 30 miles, but it took over an hour. So our original arrival time was going to be like
2:56. I would say about 3.
Yeah, so 3-ish.
And it is 5.
But it is after 5 o'clock. But fortunately, you know, check-in goes, it started at 4. Some of our group are already here, so hopefully they have our tent spots picked out. And we just have to unload, put things away. And we are eyeing this porta potty coming up because we have been in this car a very long time. So we'll see how that goes. But that's the story for now. We will check in later.
Bye.
Okay, happy Friday morning. We are getting ready to go see off our first runner. There are still teams packing in, coming in. They have later start times, but we do have an early start time. So the whole gang is here. We're going to go cheer on our runner number one. There's our runners over there. Melissa and Desiree are getting prepped for their run. And once we see them off, I'm going to get a coffee refill because I'm ready.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and through the perilous fight, o'er the brown.
I think they're about to come. People are moving. Oh, here they come. Okay, it is Friday evening. It is 5:30. My first run is finally coming up. I am the last runner on our team, so I have the last cycle. So it's 5:30 in the evening. I should be running probably around 6, but you can see the sun's already down, so it will be dark. So decked out with my light, all the things. We're just having fun hanging out. Everyone's having a blast so far. Totally not worried about time, just going out and having fun. That's the update for now. I'll let you know how it goes.
Yes, it does.
Okay, so we finished our nighttime runs. I had the yellow loop first. It was right after dark, so I think we went out around 6:30, and I ate dinner after that. That one was wild. There was actually a rattlesnake on the trail. So he was huge. We came up to a group of runners that was stopped. And so we were like, hey, is there a bottleneck, you know, here on the trail? And they were like, well, actually, no, there's a huge rattlesnake, and he's very pissed off. So people were kind of blazing a trail around where he was to cut across through the woods. And so that's what we did. And then of course, you know, the Ragnar people went, kind of changed things up until the snake was moved. So that was exciting, I guess. And then I was able to kind of rest, didn't really sleep because it was noisy. People are up and about all night long with people running, their legs of the race. But I did get some rest during the night. And then my second leg, which was the green loop, was at about 5 a.m. So we went out very dewy. I unfortunately had on my glasses, and so my glasses fogged up over and over again. But fortunately I was running with a partner, so I just took my glasses off. Can't really see without my glasses, but I was like, I'm just gonna watch your feet and follow you. So that worked out. So now I've got contacts, sunglasses, I've got the red loop left, which is the longest and hardest. Our team did get behind pace, so they are letting us double up runners here in the last set so that we can still finish at a decent time before things start shutting down here. So we're going to be running with some friends, and that's it. We're starting to pack up. So that's the update here. Down there? That's cool. There's Jody. Woo woo! Michelle!
Get out of the way.
Oh, Allie's limping. Okay, we're gonna have to get her to the med tent.
She looked like that.
Was she really limping that bad?
She's like, it's gonna be spicy.
Thank you.
Oh, they're all wearing their teal shirts too. All right, I'm walking this one so I can video it. Oh, and you look down, you get a little dizzy. It's not real flat either.
Because
in Bowling Green, Ohio, it's only black squirrels on campus.
And our campus has so many
white ones.
Yeah, it's just the
run of the walk. It's, I was saying, I'm just waiting for instruction. and I'm... Yeah. Is there more coming? Okay.
Oh.
Okay, so this is a run?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Ah! Okay. Oh my god. Is her ankle gonna do that one?
I don't have a shoes on.
Do it, do it, do it! Yeah. If you've got good grips on your shoes, it's fine.
We got you coming.
Yeah.
You better take off fast though.
Yep, lean into it. Yeah!
Lean.
Yeah!
Woo! Yeah! Yes, so thank you, trail shoes.
Yep. What are we on right now? This is a lot of perfect timing.
Yeah.
That's okay. Yeah. Seriously, I would not have the balls to pick a bike up that.
That must have been what Melissa was talking about when she's like, there's parts I had to climb.
That's probably it, yeah.
Well, the one that we have.
Oh Lord.
And they have it set up so runners go one way and bikes go the other.
Yeah.
And sometimes you could.
Yeah.
So you're like flying around the corner, you're like jumping over the bridge.
Yeah. Little bridge. Yeah. Yeah, those bike ramps. I'm assuming this is a ledge up here because there's a board. Big root to hop over. Okay, last loop is done. We got our medals, we took our team pictures. We are tired, we are exhausted, we are flipping starving. So we are loading up the cars. We're gonna go grab some late lunch in all of our stink and glory. I am soaked. Go Moms on the Run. We had so much fun.